Dear student, in today's lecture we start a problem based on chapter electrostatic. We start with the MCQ. So MCQ number one from the exercise of electrostatic. A parallel plate capacitor is charged and then isolated. The effect of increasing plate separation on charge, potential, capacitance respectively are. So we know that capacity of parallel plate capacitor is given by this formula. Now, if D increased, then what happened to charge, potential, and capacitance that we have to discuss? So, first point we discuss about charge. You remember here, charge does not depend on this D. So, Q is constant. So, first option is constant. You can see in option A is constant. In option C, it start with constant. D also start with constant. So, he to cut hote. So, option B is eliminated. Now, second one is potential. Second one, potential we have to discuss. So, we know that C is equal to Q by V. So V is equal to Q by C. So by that we can discuss what happened to the potential. So before that we discuss about capacitance. C is equal to A epsilon 0 K by D. D increases, then C decreases. So answer here, C decreases. C decreases, you can see here, C means third point, decreases, it is in the option A and option D. So here in the option C, it written increases, so this option is eliminated. So either the answer is option A or option D. Now let me check the potential. So here the potential is C, Q by C. C decreases means potential increases. So V increases. So V increases. And V increases is written in option D. You can see here. So option D is the right answer for this MCQ 1. Now next question is MCQ number 2 from exercise. Now see here, a slab of material of dielectric constant K has same area A as the plate of parallel plate capacitor and thickness 3 by 4 multiplied by D, where D is the separation of plate, the change in capacitance when slab is inserted between the plate is. So when the dielectric slab is between the plates of capacitor, then capacity is given by formula A epsilon 0 divided by D minus T plus T by K. So this is the formula. Now in that formula, let me find out this D minus T plus T by K, and then we substitute. So D as it is minus thickness, it is 3 by 4 D plus thickness is 3 by 4 D by K. Now here we can take D common. So it is 1 minus 3 by 4. Plus 3 by 4k. Now in that D, so it is coming 4 minus 3 means 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4k. So D, let me do the cross multiplication. 4k plus 12 डिवाइडेड बाय 16 के. नाउ हियर वी कैन टेक 4 कॉमन फ्रॉम न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर डी. सो 4 बाय 4 एंड टू दिस के प्लस 3 डिवाइडेड बाय 4 के. सो दिस गेट कैंसल. So we get formula here. T in a bracket k plus 3 divided by 4k. So let me substitute here this value. So we get a epsilon 0 divided by d. So k plus 3 divided by 4k. That 4k we can shift up. So we get a epsilon 0 by d in a bracket 4k divided by k plus 3. And this is the answer. And you can see this is the option D. So option D is the right answer for this question. Now next MCQ, and it is MCQ number 3 from exercise. The energy stored in capacitor and dissipated during charging a capacitor, bear a ratio. Now you remember one thing here. So here, energy stored is given by formula half CV square, as well as energy dissipated in capacitor, it is also given by this formula. So when we are taking the ratio of this, we get this 1:1. Now next MCQ is MCQ number 4. A charge plus Q minus Q are placed at point A and B. You can see here at point A and at point B respectively, which are at a distance 2L apart. You can see distance 2L. This is the midpoint of A and B. Work done in moving a charge Q along the semicircle CRD in the figure below. So we have to find out work done. So we can use the formula of potential. So this work by charge, a potential difference. So work done is equal to V into Q, potential difference into charge. So work done to move a charge along this semicircular path. So work done is equal to potential difference. So we are moving charge between the two points C and D. So potential difference at D, potential at D minus potential at C into charge is Q, capital Q charge we are moving. Now we have to find out this potential at point D minus potential at point C. So here, let me substitute potential at point D. So this is a D point. So when we are finding potential at D, we have to find out potential at D due to this plus Q charge and at due to this minus Q charge also. So in that, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is coming common. So that we are taking out. So potential at point D due to this plus Q charge. So Q by distance. Distance is, this is 2L and that distance is L. So 3L. Okay. Now due to this minus Q charge, it is coming. Due to this minus Q charge at point D. So it is coming minus Q by distance is L. Again, minus sign. Then potential at C. Potential at C again due to both the charges, due to plus Q charge, it is Q by L. And due to this minus charge, it is minus क्यू बाय, अगर डिस्टेंस ऑफ द सी फ्रॉम द माइनस क्यू चार्ज इज एल, सो दैट वी हैव टू सॉल्व 1/4 pi epsilon 0 q by 3l minus q by l minus q by l plus q by l. So these get cancelled. So it is 1/4 pi epsilon 0 into this capital Q. So that capital Q I will write it here. So here q by 3l minus, so let us write here 3q minus 3l. So here we get q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 in a bracket q minus 3q, so minus 2q divided by 3l. So let us write it remaining steps here. So q upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Okay. This minus 2q by 3l. So it is coming minus 2q divided by 12 pi epsilon 0 l. So we get the final answer. So 2 6 are 12. So we get the final answer of the work done, minus q into q divided by 6 pi epsilon 0 l. So this is the work done, and you can see this work done is written in the option A. So option A is the right option for this question. Now question number 5. It's MCQ number 5 from exercise. A parallel plate capacitor has circular plate of radius 8 cm. Means it is 8 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Plate separation 1 mm. Means it is 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. What will be the charge on plate if the potential difference 100 volt, we can write 10 raised to 2 volt, is applied. So we have to find out here charge. We know that C is equal to Q by V. So Q is equal to CV. So we can write here C is equal to A epsilon 0 D divided by D into V. So here area is not given, but it's circular plate. So area is pi r square epsilon 0 into V divided by D is the formula. In that formula, we have to substitute. So pi is 3.14 multiplied by r is 8 into 10 raised to minus 2 square into epsilon 0 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 into V is 10 raised to 2 divided by D, and D is 1 into 10 raised to minus. So this we have to solve. So it is 3.14 into 8 square is 64, 10 raised to minus 2 square is minus 4, multiplied by this 8.85 into 10 raised to minus 12 into it is 10 raised to minus 10 divided by 10 raised to minus 6. Now here 8.85 into 64 into 3.14. So that we have to solve. Maybe so by that answer we can conclude that 1780 is the answer by that. And here 10 raised to minus 14 divided by 10 raised to minus 6, 10 raised to minus 11 it is coming. So after solving this, 1.780 into 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb. So the answer for this question is option A. Now next question is problem number 11 from exercise. A charge 6 microcoulomb is placed at origin. You can see here. At origin, you can see here 6 microcoulomb charge. And another charge, minus 5 microcoulomb, is placed on y axis at A. The coordinates are 0, 6.0. So x coordinate is 0 and y coordinate is 6. It means that this distance is 6 meter. Calculate the point number A. Calculate the total electric potential at point P. So at point P, we have to find out potential. Whose coordinates are 8.0, 0. X coordinate is 8. It means that this distance is 8 meter. Okay. Second point, calculate work done to bring a proton from infinity to a point P. So what is significance of negative sign? Now in this problem, what they given here? So we say that this charge as a Q1, minus 5 microcoulomb. So that we converted into coulomb by multiplying 10 raised to minus 6. Second charge is 6 microcoulomb. In coulomb, it is 6 into 10 raised to minus. So distance is R1, is AP. And this distance of this point P, distance of the P from this one is, we can use Pythagoras. You know that this is 6, this is 8. By Pythagoras, you can find out it's 6 square plus 8 square is 100. 100 root 100 means 10. This is 10 meter. So it is 10. And this R2 distance means distance of the point from the charge is, it is 8. You can see this is 8. So why we find out this distance? Because we require distance of the point P from both the charges. So charge 1 and charge 2. So these are the distances. Now the potential at point P is the potential due to the charge minus 5 microcoulomb plus potential due to charge 6 microcoulomb. So V is equal to V1 plus V2. So we can write the formula. You know that V is given by formula 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. So we use this potential formula and we have written the formula of the potential. So we get this formula. Now we have to substitute the values. You know that here 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 is 9 into 10 raised to 9 in SI. So with that, we can take that common. And this 10 raised to minus 6 is also common in the value of charge. That is also taken common. Then here we can write the charge value is minus 5. The 10 raised to minus 6 is taken common. Minus 5 by 10 plus 6 by 8. So after solving this calculation, we get the answer 2.25 into 10 raised to 3 volt. This is the potential at point P due to both the charges. Similarly, in point B, we have to find out work done to bring a proton from infinity to point P. So work done in bringing a proton from infinity. So we can write a formula of the work done is equal to the formula of potential energy. Or simply we can use this potential formula. Potential is work by charge. This formula we already used in the previous MCQ. So work done is V into Q. This minus sign indicates that this work is done against the electrostatic force or against the direction of electric intensity and so on. Now here, potential is known. Just we obtain the potential. And the charge of proton is equal to the charge of electron. So 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. And this minus sign as it is. After solving this, we get work done is equal to minus 3.6 into 10 raised to minus 16 joule. And this is the work done to bring a proton from infinity to point P. Negative sign, work is done against the electrostatic force. Now, next question is प्रॉब्लम नंबर 10 फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज. डाइपोल मोमेंट ऑफ वाटर मॉलिक्यूल इज, डाइपोल मोमेंट जनरली रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय पी, 6.3 × 10⁻³ कूलम मीटर. अ सैंपल ऑफ वाटर कंटेंट 10⁻²⁰ मॉलिक्यूल्स, नंबर ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल्स हुज डाइपोल मोमेंट आर ओरिएंटेड इन एन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड स्ट्रेंथ. सो दिस इज इलेक्ट्रिक इंटेंसिटी. कैलकुलेट वर्क डन टू रोटेट डाइपोल फ्रॉम देयर इनिशियल ओरिएंटेशन टू वन इन विच ऑल द डाइपोल्स आर परपेंडिकुलर. Now here, let's see the solution here given. So dipole moment, electric intensity is given, and the number of molecules. Now work done is given by formula PE cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Let me substitute the values. Theta 1 is here 0 and theta 2 is here 90. So after, you know that cos 90 is 0. So this term get cancelled, we get PE cos theta. So it is P, this is E, and cos theta means cos 0 is 1. So this is the values. Then after doing the multiplication, we get the answer. So work done is equal to 1.575 × 10⁻²⁴, and this is work done to rotate dipole. Now pay attention here, this is work done to rotate dipole for single molecule, but how many molecules are there? 10⁻²⁰. So total work done we find out. So it is 10⁻²⁰ multiplied by this work done for the single molecule. So let me solve this one. 10⁻²⁰ multiplied by this. So after solving this, we get a work done, and it is 1.575 × 10⁻³. This is total work done to rotate dipole. Now next question, it's a problem number 12 from exercise. A parallel plate capacitor with air between the plate. Each plate has area 6 × 10⁻³ meter square, and the separation between the plate is 2 mm, and this is D, or in meter 2 × 10⁻³ meter. Calculate capacitance of capacitor. Take it one by one. Let's see the first given here. So given this area, radius, sorry, separation between the plate is there. So we can write D for this. And we have to find out capacitance charge on capacitor. Take it. The first point, capacitance. So capacitance is given by this formula. So this is D. Yeah? So epsilon 0 is 8.85 × 10⁻². In SI system, multiplied by area divided by D. D in meter. After solving this, we get capacitance is 2.655 × 10⁻²⁻¹ farad. Second point, charge on plates of capacitor. So charge, you know that C is equal to Q by V. So charge is CV. So C we already have, and V is given 100 volt. So we get the calculation. This C multiplied by V. So only the power changes. 2.655 655 into 10 raised to minus 9 coulomb is the answer. Third point, change in charge of capacitor. You can see the point C. How would charge on capacitors on the plates be affected if 2 mm thick mica sheet whose dielectric constant is 6 inserted between the plates and the voltage supply remains connected? So we already know that the capacity change in the charge is equal to K times the original charge when we inserted the dielectric slab. So we get of K is 6 and the Q is here. We substitute Q and that Q multiplied by 6 is the answer. So here we get answer 1.593 into 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb is the answer for this problem. Now next question is question number 13 from exercise. Find the equivalent capacitance between P and Q. So area is A and separation between the plate is D. This is first combination and this is the second combination. We have to find out capacitance. Now let's see the solution here. So here are three capacitors. This is, here you can see three tires. This is the first capacitor, this is second and third. They are connected in series. So you know that in series, so the capacity is, resultant capacity is 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. So that formula we have to use here. So resultant capacity in series is this. And here, C1, C2, C3 is how much? So here C1 is A epsilon 0 K1 divided by distance is 3 by 3. You can see here distance between these two plates is D by 3 and the dielectric constant is K. So you know that C is equal to A epsilon 0 K by D is the formula of capacity. So by that formula, so only this K and this D is changing. Take a by that. We have written this. Now let me substitute C1, C2, C3 in the equation, this equation. So we get 1 by C is equal to this D by 3 shifted up. We get this after substitution. We have to solve this to get the answer. Let me take D by 3 common. Then after taking D by 3 common, what we get here? So here 1 by epsilon 0 plus 1 by 3 epsilon 0 plus 1 upon 6 A epsilon 0. So after adding this, we get 9 upon 6 A epsilon 0 and this D by 3. So this is 1 by C. We have to write C. Okay, we have to write C by using that. So 3, 3 is a 9. Okay, and 3, 2 is a 6. So we can write it is D upon 2A epsilon 0. So C is equal to 2A epsilon 0 divided by D. This is the capacity of this first combination. So for this. Now similar manner for the second combination also we have to find out. Now these two are in the series. In the series, this first, let's say first, the second, and this is third. So this second and third, they are in series. And first and this combination, they are in parallel. Now let me solve in similar way. This second arrangement is equivalent to the first, is equivalent to first capacitor in parallel with the series combination of second and third. This is 1, 2, 3. Now here, the series combination we find out for 2 and 3. You know that in series capacities are added. C is equal to C2 plus C3. This is C2, this is C3. You can see here, this K is, or you can write like this way also, A epsilon 0 सो यह एरिया इज सेम, ठीक है, ए एप्सिलॉन जीरो के वन बाई डी वन प्लस ए एप्सिलॉन जीरो के टू बाई डी टू, आफ्टर सब्स्टिट्यूटिंग दिस वी गेट दिस, सो एरिया इज ए बाई टू एंड के हियर 3 and 6. Now we have to simplify this. So this we can write after simplification 18 a epsilon 0 divided by d by 9. Just wait here. We can take two common here. This two get cancelled. Then 3 a epsilon 0 by d plus 6 a epsilon 0 by d. So it is coming. Just wait. Hello, student. So I think here some printing mistake is there. So that's why I erase this problem again. Now see here. So this combination, this is 1, 2, 3. So this 2 and 3. So they are in series, so we find out their capacitance first. So the capacitance in series, so 1 by C S is equal to 1 by, let's say, C2 plus 1 by C3, so is equal to, so 1 upon C2 is, you know that C is equal to epsilon 0 K by D. So how much is the area? So it is area A by 2, epsilon 0, and this K is 3, divided by D is D by 2. So this is C2 plus 1 by C3, area multiplied by epsilon 0 multiplied by K divided by D by 2. Okay, now we can cancel here. So this two get cancelled. So we get the next equation is equal to, so this d we can shift up, d upon 3 a epsilon 0 plus d upon 6 a epsilon 0. Now this is 1 upon cs is equal to, now we can write here 2d upon 6 a epsilon 0 plus d upon 6 a epsilon 0. So we get here 3d upon 6 a epsilon 0. It is 1 upon cs. So it is 3 ones are 3 twos are. So we get here d upon 2 a epsilon 0. So cs is equal to 2 a epsilon 0 by d. You note down. This is a series capacitance of this second and third combination. Now here we can write the capacity is equal to the first capacitor. Now you can see here. So this is the first one, and this series combination of 2 and 3. They are in parallel. So I can write the formula here. This C1 plus CS is the total capacitance. So C1, how we write by this formula? We can write CS by this formula. Area A by 2, epsilon 0, K is 4, divided by D is, so this is D, plus 2A epsilon 0 by D. Now here 2 twos are 4. So we get 2A epsilon 0 by D plus 2A epsilon 0 by D. So here we get the answer. 4 epsilon 0 by d is the capacity of this combination. So this is the answer. Now you go through this question. This is a little tricky, but this is easy, not that much difficult. Now today we stop here.